offensive, and it is already underway. It is not just fighting involved here. They're really setting up governance, and that means, in the first order, trying to establish some sense of law and order, some sense of city services in Kandahar. It looks a lot more like nation building, and I don't mean that in a bad way, just what it is. It looks a lot more like nation building than it does like D-Day. And those I think it's more appropriate to call it an operation than an offensive. It's already happening, and they know they're on a tight timeline.
Rachel, it's Savannah. I wonder how you're finding your own access there, your ability to talk to soldiers, especially in light of course, the Rolling Stone article, which led to the fall of a general. How are you being greeted there, and have you been able to talk candidly with some of our troops?
Savannah, it's been surprising to me the degree of access that we've been able to gain. And part of that is just credit to the very experienced NBC News crew with whom I'm with. They know how to get stuff done, and they know how to get me in to see people. I'm a real newbie around here, and so I really appreciate that experience. But I'll also tell you that the military here, from the very top level, which is some of what we've been dealing with, has been very happy to give us access. I did a battlefield circulation, as I said, with the general. I talked with Afghan police officers. I talked with Afghan civilians. I talked with members of the U.S. military here, all the way down to a private first class, people who are on the guns at the front lines of those police checkpoints around Kandahar City. They've been very willing to talk. The ground rules have been very, very open. And I think that what they essentially want the media to be able to convey about what they're doing is a little more nuanced than we've been getting in the right. U.S. media. It's not just offensive to offensive to offensive. They really do have a governance piece that's that explains that deadline, and that explains most of what they do every day.
You know, two things that jumped out at me in that Rolling Stone piece that we have not talked enough about was General McChrystal's assessment of the margia of what's going on there and the first initial attempt there using the troop serves and doing government in a box. And then the second part was some quotes from some soldiers who didn't like General McChrystal's rules of engagement. After talking with folks on the ground in Kandahar, what have you heard about the issue on rules of engagement and what they want General Petraeus to do? And second, what have they learned from Marja that they think that they can do better in Kandahar?
Two really good questions. On the issue of rules of engagement, we're starting to hear, I think, again, from the military, a desire for more nuance in the reporting and a wish for more more depth of understanding, I think, from the American public on this. The rules of engagement are legal terms, and they're agreed by all of the 40-something countries that are technically part of the coalition here. Expecting to see a change in the rules of engagement, if you're expecting that, you are going to be disappointed. That's not going to happen. Now, the tactical directives that the brass here give to soldiers in the field in terms of how they engage, how they implement those rules of engagement, that might happen, but it's going to be subtle. Remember, General Petraeus is the guy who wrote the book, wrote the counterinsurgency field manual for the Army, and was part of setting up this strategy here. So I don't think we should expect to see a huge divorce in the approach to the war between the way General McChrystal approached it and the way General Petraeus did. On Marja and Kandahar are not apples and apples. It's more apples and oranges. Marja is a place where there was no police, no governance whatsoever. It was a real lawless Taliban stronghold. They went in there with a full-on military offensive and are trying to hope that government follows that. It's very difficult. Kandahar is a city that I walked around relatively comfortably. I spent time there on foot, as well as in vehicles, as well as in choppers. Kandahar is a place where there are police and there is governance. They're not building something from the ground up. It's really more about nation building there than it is about fighting street to street.
All right, Rachel Maddow, it's good to have you with us live from Kabul. We'll be watching for your reporting. Thank you. And a reminder, everybody, the Rachel Maddow Show broadcasts live from Kabul, Afghanistan, tonight at 9 Eastern, right here on MSNBC.